Hey, Shalom, Shalom. I want to start off by saying, call Halal Yahweh, Bahashim Yabushah, Bahashim Rukah Kudash. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders, a great millstone, who rule well, and grace and peace to you elect around the four corners of the globe, believing and pushing this truth in all sincerity. May the blessing of election be upon your houses. This is your fellow servant, Rukaya, from the GMS Orlando camp. And tonight, I wanted to speak on being quickly without care when it comes to the things of this world, you know, when it comes to the cares of this world, you know, just building off of a scripture I was reading in Wisdom of Solomon, the sixth chapter, which Lord's willing will be able to read here pretty soon. But nevertheless, man, you know, hearing this truth of ours, you got to have a tough skin and a strong mind, you know, or else you'll get swept up and swept out of this truth, you know. And if you care about the things of this world, you know, what people got to say about you, what people think about you, you know, what people say, then it'll slowly eat at your mind to the point where bit by bit, man, you'll be swept out of the truth, man. You know, you'll be swept right back into the world because you care about it too much, you know. And that's not somewhere, you know, we want to find ourselves, especially coming into the times that we're coming into, man. You know, and in all reality, the only thing that really matters is this truth, man. You know, this the brotherhood, man, this ministry, the will of Yahweh by Shemiah was shot, man. That's the only thing we really care about, man. When it comes to these different family members, in all reality, they're just relatives, man. You know, they just share the same blood as you, man. But when it comes to these family members, when it comes to these relatives, when it comes to these significant others, when it comes to these so-called friends and co-workers or whatever, man, at the end of the day, they don't matter. All right, what really matters is the brothers, man. The brothers matter. You know, this ministry matters. The work matters. You know, that's what really matters, man, because that's what's going to translate into the kingdom, man. This other shit is going to be swept away. You know, and if you care about this other shit, you're going to get swept away right along with it, man. You know, if you care about what people think about you, it's going to hinder you from doing the will of Yahweh by Shemiah Washai. If you care about what people got to say about you, it's going to hinder you from doing the will of Yahweh by Shemiah Washai. You think brothers care about what people got to say? These niggas is bugged out here in the world, man. All of these niggas, man. These niggas believe in America. All right, it don't matter what they got to say, man. They say we bugged out. They say we crazy. To hell with them, man. Who really bugged out at the end of the day, man? These niggas believe in America, Babylon the Great. Like the elder in Chicago says, man. These niggas believe in America. They believe in the American dream. They believe, some of these niggas still believe they're a color in the crayon box, man. Who really bugged out at the end of the day? You know, and just like the scripture says in Ezekiel, lo, it will come, man. We're going to see, man. Once this prophecy comes to pass, man, we're going to see who is really bugged out and who is really living in reality, man. You know? But nevertheless, man, let's get this here in Wisdom of Solomon 6. And I'm going to start at verse 14, but the point is in 15. It says, whoso seeketh her early shall have no great travail. You know, and this is why we seek in wisdom. This is speaking about wisdom, man. This is why we seek wisdom early. This is why we seek our creator in the days of our youth, so that we don't have a great travail, man. So that we don't get swept up, you know, caught up in this judgment that's coming upon the earth. All right, to kill off these 2/3 of the nation of Israel and the rest of these heathens, man. This is why we seek wisdom early, so that we don't have great travail, man. It says, for he shall find her sitting at his doors. You know, and the Heavenly Father, you know, Yahushua is sitting at the door, waiting, knocking, waiting for us to open. You know, waiting to give us the gift of faith, waiting to give us the gift of knowledge, understanding, wisdom. You know, it says, to think there upon her is perfection of wisdom. And whoso watcheth for her shall quickly be without care, man. And you know, being restored into our right mind, man, coming into this wisdom, we quickly without care, man. We don't give a damn what these people got to say, man. To hell with them, all right? We know what's real, man. We know. That's the thing, man. We know what we worship. We know what the truth is, man. We know. It's not no ifs, ands, or buts, man. We know. Oh, yeah, well, you should know at this point in time. You should know who the true power is, man. You should know what the truth is. It's manifesting within our faces daily, man. The prophecies are hopping off the damn page, man. Not the damn page, but they hopping off the page, man. you should know, man, at this point in time. It says, to think there upon her is perfection and wisdom, and whoso watcheth for her shall quickly be without care, man. And us watching after this truth, man, us watching after the prophecies, has made us quickly without care, quickly without the care of the things of this world, man. To hell with the money, to hell with the hoes, to hell with the clothes, the cars, the money, the houses, all this bullshit, man. To hell with it, man. It's all gonna burn. It really don't matter. You know, I can't really stress that enough, man. This shit do not matter, man. What really matters is this ministry. What really matters is this work, this truth, man. Because this is everlasting. This ain't temporary. This is forever. This is forever, man. This is what matters, man. The brotherhood. Establishing a good connection with Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Establishing a good connection with the brothers as best as you can, man. That's what really matters. Because that's what's going to translate in the world to come. Not this other shit. Scripture saying 1 Timothy. Let me see if I can get that too. I think it's 2 Timothy 1 and verse 9. It's 1 Timothy. Nah, 2 Timothy. Yeah, it's 1 Timothy 6 and 7. I'm going to start at verse 6. It says, godliness with contentment is great gain. You know, you got to learn also how to be content in this truth of what you got. You know, you don't want to find yourself desiring to have what another brother has, or desiring to be in a greater office than the Heavenly Father put you in, because that's how you'll quickly destroy yourself. All right, the Lord gave us our perfect portion. All right, whatever lot we serve is the lot that the Heavenly Father imparted within our spirits. That's enough. It's according to the faith that the Heavenly Father imparted in us, man. If we the foot, then we just the foot, man. We got to play the foot. We got to play the foot to the best of our ability. You know, if you find yourself in the toe or in the heel or in the fingers or the hand or the arm or the head, you got to play that to the best of your ability. You can't play no other part, man. The head cannot play the toe. It wasn't designed to play the toe. The body won't be able to function if the head is trying to play the toe. All right? They each have their different functions, which perfects the body. You know, we got to be able to be or learn to be content, you know, with our office. And in being content with your office, man, that brings greater peace into your walk, man. That just brings peace, you know, to your situation, to your thoughts, to your spirit, man. When you're content with your office, man. You know, it says, but godliness with contentment is great gain. You know, you gain a lot spiritually and mentally when you're content with the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. You know, it says, for we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. I'm going to read that one more time. For we brought nothing into this world. You came in this world butt booty naked, balls and all. Nothing. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out, man. We can't carry money out. You see it with the damn pharaohs, man. They tried to bury all that money. Them niggas don't use that money in the heavens. That shit filthy up there in the heavens. It's of no value up there in the heavens. You can't carry your money out. You can't carry these cars, these houses, these clothes, the fashion, your shoes, the whip. You can't carry none of this out. You can't carry none of it out, man. So you constantly seeking to build upon it, constantly seeking to make it better. I got to get another house and build upon. I got to get 3 more women. I got to get some more clothes, some more money. You constantly building upon that's destroying you, man. What you really need to be building upon is your spirit, because that's what you're going to take out with you. We came in with our spirit, and that's what we're going to depart with. And however we built upon that spirit on our time on this earth, you know, living on. Let me rephrase that. You know, however we built our spirit with our time on this earth is how we're going to be judged, man. You know, we came in with our spirit. We were supposed to build upon that spirit that the Heavenly Father gave us, so that when we departed, we can cash it out, man. You know, that's what really matters. The rest of this shit do not matter, man. It says, and having, for we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. And this is not to say, man, that you shouldn't care about you know, your personal situation to the point where you just letting yourself go. No, we still supposed to upkeep ourselves. We still supposed to do the time and not let this time do us. But at the same time, you can't get too enthralled with the things of this world, man. The scriptures say, also, we're going to come back to that in 1 Timothy. But we're going to get this in 2 Timothy. In verse 3, it says, "Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier, Yehoshua Mashiach. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier." You can't entangle yourself with the things of this life. You can be in the world, just not of it. You know, it's okay to be in the world. It's okay to, you know, maneuver in this world, because that's how we gain experience, man. We got to maneuver in this world and apply the scriptures, you know, apply the wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Shemiah Washai in order to grow. But at the same time, you can't get too caught up in this world to the point where you're starting to care about it, to the point where you're starting to believe in it. You want to build and you want to stay. The goal at the end of the day is to get the hell up out of here. So when I dated you, you can't find yourself. So don't entangle yourself, you know, with the affairs of this life, man. Keep that healthy balance, you know. But going back into 1 Timothy, right? Verse 7, it says, "For we brought nothing into this world, and it's certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us therefore be content." You know, therewith be content. You know, we have food, we have raiment. All right, the Lord, let me get this in Psalms. The Lord woke us up with our daily benefits. This is Psalm 68 and 19. "Blessed be the Lord who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the power of our salvation." Salah. You know, and the Lord daily loads us with our benefits, man. The Lord gives us the food we need to eat. All right. He wakes us up with our eyes, with our arms, with our limbs, with our full range of motion. He wakes us up with all of our senses, even a sixth sense of understanding. All right. He wakes us up with the names. He wakes us up with the brotherhood. He wakes us up in our right mind with sound doctrine. All right. The Lord renews our benefits daily. So with having these daily benefits, it's good that we be content with it, man. Be content with our daily benefits. Like one of the brothers in the camp says, anything outside of that, man, is really wicked, man. If you're seeking anything outside of that, that's off, man. Take what the Lord gives you. Build upon what the Lord gives you, man. Don't seek nothing else outside of that, man. But going back, it's kind of going off the topic, but, you know, we're just flowing with the Spirit. It says, "And having food and raiment, let us therefore be content. But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition." Man, it said it drowns men. You could drown out here, man, in the cares of this life. It's cold, man. It says, "But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare," because if you're constantly chasing after money, it comes, the demons come with that, man. You know, you constantly got to get more. You want to be rich. That comes with demons, man. It comes with snares. People want to trap you up. Your mind will trap you. You trap yourself up, man. "And into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which, while some covet after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows." You know? But let's hit this back in Wisdom of Solomon 6, and then we'll close it out. All right? Because the point is really made. Point being, man, you got to be quickly without caring this truth, man. You can't care what people got to say. You can't care what these motherfuckers got to think about you, man. What they say about you, man. What your family members say. What your girlfriend say. Your boyfriend say. Whatever it may be. You know, your wife, your husband. Whatever it may be. You can't care, man. All right? If brothers cared about what people had to say or think about them, we wouldn't be out there on the highways and byways, man. We wouldn't be fulfilling the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Caring about what people think hinders you from fulfilling the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. If Yahweh Shai cared about what every motherfucker had to say about him in Jerusalem, all them niggas, then he wouldn't fulfill the will of the Heavenly Father. He wouldn't have fulfilled the will of the Heavenly Father. He wouldn't have went upon the cross, man. He wouldn't have did what he did, man. He wouldn't have went through those fiery trials. Because them niggas would have talked him out of it. His conscience would have talked him out of it. Nah, man, you crazy. Yeah, these niggas don't love you. You don't want to die on that cross for these niggas. Nah. His conscience would have talked him right out of it, man. Likewise, us in this truth, man. If you care about what people got to say, you'll talk yourself out of a lot of things. You'll talk yourself out of the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. You bug yourself out of the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. You know? You got to care about what really matters, which is this truth, man. This brotherhood, this ministry. That is what really matters. Think about it, man. It says, Wisdom of Solomon 6 and 15, to think that upon her is perfection of wisdom, and whoso watcheth for her quickly shall quickly be without care. For she goeth about seeking such as are worthy of her, showing herself favorably unto them in the ways, and meeteth them in every thought. For the very true beginning of her is the desire of discipline, and the care of of discipline is love. And love is the keeping of her laws, and the giving heed unto her laws is the assurance of incorruption. And incorruption maketh us near unto the Heavenly Father. All right, so I'm going to get this last one. In 2nd Esdras 14 and 14, and then I'll close it out. It says, let go from the mortal thought. It says, let go from the mortal thoughts. Nah, I'm going to start at 13. It says, now therefore set thine house in order and reprove thy people, man. Thy house starting with your body. All right, set your mind, set your spirit, set your body in order. You know, set your priorities straight in the spirit and in the mind. Focus on what really matters, man. All right, cleanse yourself. You know, it says, now therefore set your house in order and reprove thy people. Comfort such as them as be in trouble, now renounce corruption. Let go from thee mortal thoughts. Cast away the burdens of man. Put off not a weak nature, man. Let go of these mortal ass thoughts, man. Mortal thoughts lead to mortal deaths, all right? Immortal thoughts lead to immortality, man. You got to set your mind on the everlasting, the immortality, man, that is for to come, all right? It says, let go from the mortal thoughts. Cast away the burdens of man. Put off not a weak nature. And set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from these tongues, man. Set aside these heavy thoughts. All right, it's going to weigh you down from this race, from this walk of ours, man. We got to keep a steady pace in order to endure and make it to the end. We got to keep a steady pace. But if you have these weights on you, it's going to slow you down. It's going to make you tired. It's going to make you fall out. So set these weights aside. It's no need. It's no need to be macho. It's no need to be Superman. You know, just run the race. Put them weights to the side, man. Fuck what these motherfuckers got to say. Fuck what they thinking. Man, to hell with them, man. These niggas is bugged out, man. It says, set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and hasty to flee from these times. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen shall be done hereafter. All right, but the point is being made, man. You know, with that being said, not going to talk for much too longer, man. Just, you know, realize what is the top priority, you know, in your life. The top priority in your life should be Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Should be this truth, the ministry, the brotherhood. That should be the top priority in your mouth. Everything outside of that do not matter. It's a secondary. We almost at the end, man. You know, with that being said, man, just endure. All right. Cast away the cares of this life, man. Set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto you, man. And endure. Endure. We almost to the end, man. You know, we almost to the end. Set those weights to the side and get on that steady pace. All right, the Lord is coming quickly. Hold that fast to that which you have. Shalom.